to Frankie's Forest. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you my new orchids that I got. And you'll immediately be thinking, why are there paper towels over your orchids? Well, let me explain. So my cousin had some people at her job who had these orchids and they were about to throw them out. And she knew that I loved orchids, and so she took them and gave them to me. And now I'm trying to care for them. Unfortunately, I don't have any orchid substrate, which is pretty sad for an orchid-based YouTuber, but it is going to be coming soon. So the three that I have are in here. I believe are catasetums. I'm not exactly sure. If any of you guys are orchid experts or know a lot about orchids, please let me know. And also, the only reason why I have paper towels in here is just to keep it moist since I don't have any substrate. I figured it would be better to keep all the roots moist when there's, otherwise there wouldn't be a paper towel in there and then the roots would dry out quickly. So I keep a paper towel in here. And I always make sure, twice a day, I make sure to spray it with my plant sprayer I use just for my plants. And I do that, and that's all I do. And then it keeps the humidity pretty good for them. So these are these. I'm not exactly sure what they are. They do have little, I'm not sure exactly which one, and I don't want to go messing around with them, but in a future video, I'll show you. One of these bulbs, one of these pseudobulbs, actually has another baby cakey pseudobulb growing off of the bottom of it. And so I think that it'll be doing well, especially since I've been keeping it very well watered, per se. Next up is this dendrobium, I believe. I'm not exactly sure what this one is. It does seem to have a flower spike. I'm not sure if this is a flower spike or just a part of the cane that the leaves haven't gotten onto. But it does have, I'm not exactly sure what that is, but it looks like a cakey. I'm not sure. So I'll have to figure out what that is. The funny thing with this orchid, though, is that it doesn't have roots. It was actually together with these orchids, so I'm assuming that they're the same type. I know that these are some type of dendrobium. I don't think they're dendrobium nobilis, because the dendrobium nobili I have looks much different. I'm not exactly sure what this one is. It doesn't have any leaves, but the canes are perfectly healthy and happy, which is good. And also I'm using this method, and I just had a little bit of moss left over, so I put it in here. And since it doesn't have any roots, I know, look at it. Very little roots. I did put a little bit, band around here to keep the substrate on, but as you can see, just by the moss, you can't even see any, there we go. Yeah, there's two little roots. I don't know if that's enough to sustain the plant, so I've been keeping it extremely moist so new roots can grow. And if you guys have any other suggestions on how to promote new root growth, please let me know, especially if you have any advice for orchids who are in this state of emergency, as is this one. Other than that, I might as well just miss this one now because I missed it earlier today, but it's the afternoon now. It's been pretty hot and it is near a bright window, and so I'm gonna just make sure it's a little misty. So other than that, I'll keep you guys updated on these orchids. I'm sorry I've been out for a while. It's just been pretty crazy around here. But I know, no excuse. I should have been uploading, but I haven't. So anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed. Please let me know if you have any care tips on these kind of orchids, and please also help me identify these species of orchids. Without further ado, please remember to subscribe to my channel, and also leave a like on the video and share this and other videos with your friends. So I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you guys on the next video. Bye.